just can't believe I'm yours. Every day I look at you and I think I must have done something good to deserve you.
Hey everyone, Graham Ehlers Sheldon here, your friendly neighborhood Sigma Cine ambassador. And like you, I had a couple of questions about camera to cloud technology. Question one, does it work? Question two, can it work on an actual production in the field? We're gonna answer all those questions and more, and we're also gonna show you how to set up your own camera to cloud workflow as we make a mini documentary in the Hawaiian Islands on the island of Kauai using the Atomos Ninja 5 monitor, the Atomos Connect, the Sigma FP camera, and this bonded internet backpack from Scalera. This kit is all you're gonna need to get started with camera to cloud, and we're gonna start filming right now.
Oh yeah!
Part of our camera to cloud workflow, we're gonna need to consider our internet connection. You have a few different options. You can go with bonded cellular, like we're using today. You could go with a satellite-based solution. Or maybe you tether off of your cell phone or a mobile hotspot of some kind. If you're filming on a soundstage, good old-fashioned Wi-Fi might work just fine. The point is, you have multiple options for multiple different productions. Pick the best one that works for your shoot. Honestly, before we came out here, I was pretty stressed about the internet connectivity part of this. I mean, it's just not something I'm used to be honest. You have to add another thing, you need this backpack, but it's really simple to set up. If you've ever set up an at-home router, I mean, it's honestly even a little easier than that. You just add your battery to the backpack. In our case, we're using a gold mount that lasts for hours, and then you just connect to it like you do an at-home router. The password's printed right on the side, and then you have this nifty little backpack that you can carry around, and then you just have internet. So it's been kind of seamless, honestly. We've had internet all over the island, including at sea, which is still blowing my mind. Let's talk kit. The hero might be the Sigma FP camera right here. I have an 8-sin camera cage on it, and then it's paired with the 65mm T1.5. It's the newest member of the Cine Prime family for Sigma. It's adapted from the native L mount of the FP to PL using the MC31 adapter, which is one of the cooler things about the FP, is being able to adapt that L mount to all sorts of stuff. And then, of course, the FP is one of, if not the smallest, full-frame mirrorless camera on the planet. So this is a tiny rig already, made a little bit heavier by this gorgeous Cine Prime. Well worth it. Now, you could add a matte box to the front of that. I tend to go with these screw-on ND filters when I'm trying to keep the rig compact. This is 86mm ND 0.9, so that's 3 stops ND, but I have a few of these depending on how much ND I need. In terms of powering the rig, this is very cool. This is a Titan base plate from Anton Bauer, and you can actually clip out the little tripod adapter right here, and this lasts for hours. It can power the FP and the Ninja 5 monitor, which I'll get to in a second. Multiple D-tap outs, USB out, and then you just charge it through one of the D-taps with a tiny little power adapter. That brings us to the Atomos Ninja 5 monitor. It's very sunny here, and having a bright monitor that's actually daylight viewable is really important for me. Now, I've added the Atomos Connect module to the back. That's really the core of the Camera 2 cloud system. Simply add an HDMI cable out of your FP into this device right here, connect to the internet, and you're off to the races, at least when it comes to camera to cloud. And then, last bit of it for me is the various power solutions. I tend to use a lot of like dummy batteries, things like that, just to keep everything running off of the larger Titan base plate from Anton Bauer. So I use these dummy batteries. There's various brands of these available online. They all seem to work great, and that keeps the entire rig small, compact, perfect for documentary filmmaking. One of the cool things about the Atomos Ninja 5 and the Sigma FP rig is just how small and contained everything is. You do a lot of walking here on Kauai, and that's not a problem because this is just a couple of pounds. Once you have your internet connection, you need to go to Atomos Cloud Studio. Once you're in Atomos Cloud Studio, it's easy to find your Ninja 5 and Atomos Connect. Connect that device to Atomos Cloud Studio. You need to pick a tier. There's a free tier. There's a few paid tiers. And then you need to pick your destination. For us, we're going to Frame.io to collaborate so that our editors can download the proxy files and get started cutting before we're back home. One of the cool things about Atomos' technology is the idea of progressive upload. So, say I'm recording an hour-long interview. Now, depending on internet speeds, 90-ish percent of that interview might already be in the cloud by the time I hit cut. Then you just have to make up that 10% or so gap, and everything is in, for me, Frame.io. Hey, Frank, how is the weather in Burbank?
It is cloudy and muggy, but like not as beautiful for sure as it is over there, as I can see.
Well, we're getting rained on a lot, but we love it. I think that's rain coming for me right now. But have you been able to see the footage populate in Frame.io?
Yeah, I mean, everything's popping up really quick. I mean, I see a couple things popping in right now. I think you guys just stopped recording, so everything's working as it should, which is great.
Okay, so it's raining on me right now, Frank, so we're actually going to end this call, and I'm going to try to get to a drier place. Yeah, I'm going to be back in California tomorrow, but I'll see you later. I'm going to go get a raincoat or something.
Well, I mean, I'll see you in a second. You're going to be on my screen in like a second or two, so.
Okay, cool. All bye, right. Frank.
Take care. Bye.
We just finished an interview with Palenque Flores at the Ale Coco Fish Pond, and I was thinking, what are some of the reasons why camera-to-cloud workflows make sense in documentary specifically? Now, the big one for me is involving your post-production team sooner, getting those long interviews transcribed sooner, getting the project set up sooner, but beyond that, editors can see things that you can't. They might realize, oh, I don't have an insert I need here, or there's another storytelling reason why I need X shot. And they give you those suggestions while you're actually in the hard to reach place before you get back on that plane and you can't shoot anymore, at least not easily. Also, when I'm producing multiple projects at the same time, I can keep track of them all, no matter where the crew is anywhere in the world. Another remote use of camera to cloud is a small crew, big team idea. For example, there's only two of us here on Kauai filming this project. But we have a larger team back in Los Angeles and even in New York that's able to view the footage as it's coming in and give feedback in almost real time. Sometimes I can't travel to a particular country, or I might need additional B-roll shots or an additional interview. So I go ahead and hire a local crew. Now I can send them a camera to cloud rig, or they could rent one locally. But the key thing is there, it's not a trust thing. You just have the confidence knowing that their footage is gonna fit in to your documentary and match the style that you've already established. Also, proxy files could end up being your actual files in the case of your memory card getting damaged by salt water, or even local security forces taking your memory cards, which is a true story, which has happened to me. So, those are just a couple ideas I had for camera to cloud workflows when it comes to documentary filming. Ooh. that's it for us using camera-to-cloud technology in the field in Kauai to make a mini documentary. And as I'm standing here talking to you, the editor is already working on the introduction for this video back in California. How cool is that? And this isn't movie mud that you see here on the Scalera backpack. This is actual mud because we really put the camera to cloud system through its paces off the beaten path. Thanks for watching, guys. Ooh, looks like a storm's coming.